Adrien the Problem Broner will enter the ring in August to face Paulie the Magic Man Malignaggi. Ryan Mason here at Outlaws. Break down that fight. What does Broner need to do to win? What does Malignaggi need to do to win?
Malignaggi needs to stay on the outside, jab, use lateral movement, and use those straight punches. Anytime he can get in and out, that's his best way of winning. Kind of fighting like how he fought when he was younger, definitely. For Adrien Broner to win, he has to apply the pressure. He has to keep that jab in Paulie's chest. Not so much in his face, but in his chest. Because Paulie likes to slip. He likes to do that tight head movement. You know, he likes to do that. He does. And if Adrien could just stick it, just boom, dude, just come in the way he does with it, hey, he could possibly get to him. And also, Adrien needs to be more mobile on his feet. He can't just stay there, because one thing about Paulie's going to keep moving. He will keep moving. If Paulie gets to move, he's going to move. He's not going to stay there right in front of you. But there are times when Paulie will go toe-to-toe with the guy. If Paulie can handle Adrien's power, hey, it's a possibility. It could be a long night for Adrien. But Adrien's got the skills. He's got the goods to pull off this kind of win. He does. But
jump up two weight classes and win a title?
Yeah, jump up to two weight classes. But, you know, it's not like it's never been done before. Shane Mosley did it against Oscar De La Hoya. But I'll say this. And this isn't even a knock on Paulie. This is in reference to Adrien. All the boxing fans out there, you know, if this fight is made, a lot of fans are going to pick Adrien to win. I see Paulie being the underdog.
Well, they're talking about June 22nd, Mandalay Bay.
Yeah.
Get your tickets.
Hey, I'm not going to lie. I wouldn't mind seeing it. But the bottom line is this. Adrien Broner, as fast as he's becoming the star that he is, he needs, honestly, after 135, in my opinion, he needs to move up to 140 and fight those guys. Just clear out 140. Because honestly, there's more competition at 140 than there is at 147 right now. And if he cleans out 140, people can't say anything anymore. That's the bottom line, honestly. That's how I think. I know that's how a lot of fans think.
We'll have to agree to disagree, because people in the nature of just in general, if they don't like someone or they don't root for them, it doesn't matter what you do. They're always going to criticize. So you're not going to win everybody over.
You're not going to win everybody over. You can't please everybody. Nobody can please everybody. I know that.
You just got to get in the ring and fight and put on a show and go from there.
You got to get there. You got to do your job. But people want to see Adrien Broner fight guys like Lucas Matisse, guys like Danny Garcia, guys like Brandon Rios,
both
Michael Verrato.
All the people that you just mentioned have fights lined up right now.
They have fights lined up, it's true. And that's the crappy thing about Adrien Broner not being able to be matched up with them, because they do have fights lined up already. That's where I understand where the business of boxing comes into play. It does. But the thing is this. Adrien Broner, he goes up to 140. If he beats Matisse and he beats everybody else, You got to give the guy his due. You got to give the guy his due. Definitely.
There you have it. Ryan Mason talking about Adrien Broner, Paulie Malignaggi. What do you guys think about that fight? For EsNews.com, Mike Sickback reporting.